Hello everyone, welcome to Code and Learn. So in the last video, we added a logger to our service. Now in this video, we are going to add two new middlewares. One is to log the request or the incoming request so that we know what requests are coming in. And the other is injecting the logger to the request context so that we can get the logger inside the handler to log other things. So let's start by creating those two middlewares. I will create the middlewares in the logger package. So first one is AddLogger. As mentioned earlier, this middleware is going to add a logger to the request context so that in the handler, we can fetch the logger from the context and use it to log information. I will name it AddLogger. Func AddLogger, it takes a logger instance, which is slog.logger. Then the next handler function to pass the request to. So we'll say next, http.handlerfunc. And in int run, we will return the http.handlerfunc return. So middleware is something that sits between the incoming request and your handler. Depending on how you program it, it will be called either before the request is transferred to your handler or after the response has been written to your handler. So here, let us create a logger context, that is context enriched with the logger. So I will say context with logger, provide the parent context, which is the one that we get from the request, and then the logger instance. So now we have a new logger context which has logger injected to the context. Now what we will do is clone the request. It is not advisable to create a copy of request or manipulate it in any way. Instead, we can use the clone function, which returns a deep copy of R with its context changed to the passed in context. So we will pass it logger context, and then we will call next.serve.http, passing the writer and request that we got. So here, since we are calling it after all our programming logic, it will act as a before middleware. That is, before a request is passed to the handler, that is next, we will execute our code. If you were doing something like printing a statement here, that will be a after middleware. That is, after the handler func or the next has been called, the execution of the program will be passed to our middleware, where we can execute whatever we want. So after adding AddLogger, next let us add a logger middleware that will log the incoming request. Let me change the name to AddLogger middleware, or just mid. Then I can say func logger mid. Similarly, in this case, we will just get the next, which is the next handler func that we pass the control to. And in return, we use handler func again. Return handler func. In here, first thing we are going to do is fetch the logger from the request context. So we are expecting the request context to be already populated or injected with the logger. So we can say l from context, pass in the request context and fetch the logger. Now using that logger, we can do a info, that is info message. We use the info error, warn and things like these to indicate the severity of the log. Info is, as the name suggests, just for informational purposes. For now, let us just say middleware logged the request and then pass control to the next, that is serve HTTP, pass the response and writer to it. So as you can see, we are using the closures. That is, the returning function is closing upon next and using it to serve the next handler. So now in the main, let us set it up. So we already created a logger. Then here, let me create a wrapped router. Let me move the creation of the router above. To prevent any conflicts, let us name this to log, because logger is our package name also. So now let us create a wrapped router logger, which is our package. Then add logger middleware, providing it the logger or log, and then wrap the internal handler function with our logger mid and provide R. This is erroring out because we expect a handler func in our logger mid. So we need to change it to handler, which should be satisfied by router. As you can see, it is satisfied by the router. Now, instead of using R for setting up here, we just say wrapped router, and that's it. Now our request routing is set up. Let me run the program. And in a new tab, let us make a request. Even though we haven't implemented anything, we should see request being logged. It says middleware logged the request. Now we can update it to actually log something useful. So I can say path request.path. or request.url.string. Here, instead of having verbosity, we can just say request. Save it. Let's try to run our server again. Go run main.go. Try with the request again. Curl. And here we should see the request. That is, the path was news. So that's it for this lesson. What we did was creating two middlewares. First is to inject logger to the request context, and the other one is to log incoming requests. Then in the main, we first wrapped the router returned from here with the logger middleware, and then we wrapped it with AddLogger, which is going to add the logger to the request context. Now one thing here is to see the execution chain. Since we are chaining multiple routers, let us see what the chain is like or how it runs. Let me close this. In AddLogger middleware, I can just do println and say AddLogger. Then similarly, in this one, I can say fmt println logger mid. Save it, then try again. Let me just clear the console so that we are able to see what's happening here. Go run main.go, clear the console, make a request. So as you can see, AddLogger was called first, then the logger middleware. So the chaining pattern is this one will be called first, then this, and then our handler func. It goes from outer to inner. Before I forget, let me remove this and also the package that it imported. Cool. So that's it for this lesson. In next lesson, we will set up some functionality of the handlers that we created earlier. Until next time, happy coding.